Hello, dear students, very good morning to you all. In today's class, I teach you the next conditional statement or execution statement supported by Python, that is alternative execution statement. That means in today's class, I teach you all about alternative execution statement in Python. In the last class, I taught you simple conditional execution statement from the Python. Whatever I taught in my last class, just I revise for you for 1 minute. Sometimes while working with computer languages or the Python, for us necessary to execute or skip. That is, sometimes while working with Python, for us necessary to execute or skip certain block of statements based on certain condition, and is possible by conditional statements supported by Python. Python supports a simple conditional execution statement, alternative execution statement, chained conditions statement, nested conditional statements. Means in last class I taught you simple conditional execution statement. What was that? If the condition is true, then only it executes all these true block of statements, otherwise no. That's why we called it as one-way decision making statement. We looked at many examples also. And the rule also we followed. After the condition, colon must be there, tab indentation must be there for the true block of statements. If n1 is greater than n2, then only largest number is n1. If n2 is greater than n1, then only largest number is n2. This is what we studied in the last class. In today's class, I teach you the next one. What is that? Alternative execution statement in Python. This is similar to if-else statement from C language. No need to worry about that. I teach you once again. This is what we call two-way. Two-way means we have two choices, but we select one of them. We select one of the two. It executes a true block of statements or false block of statement. Any one of the two will be executed, either true block or false block. If the condition is true, then definitely machine follows true block of statements. If the condition is false, then machine follows false block of statements. That means either true block works or the false block works. That's why it is called two-way selection statement. See the syntax. If is must once again. Okay, no problem at all. Condition is also must, depending on problem. Very good. Then colon is also must. That is the rule made by developers of Python. Then true block statements will come. You can type 1 or 2 or 3 or many. Then else keyword. Again colon comes here. And this gap is must, tab indentation. And else must come here only left side. If you type like this, this is wrong. Error will come. If you type like this, it is correct. This is what we call true block. This is what we call false block. What the machine will do, what the Python interpreter will do? Python interpreter will check the condition for true or false. If it is true, machine follows these three. These will not follow. If it is false, machine will not follow these. Machine follows these things. That's what is called two-way. This is first set, this is second one. We have two choices here. First one works or the second one works. This is what all about alternative execution statement in Python. I think you understood. Please, students, listen to me, look at me, concentrate. Okay, thank you. But these are not related to if-else. As usual, these are going to work. I hope you understood. Hello, students, those are sitting at the back side, please listen to me. Okay, thank you. And now see the example. In last class, I taught you many examples, no? All those examples can be solved by using if-else also. Okay, look at this example. Python program to find largest of two numbers using alternative execution statement. Very simple. Again we read two numbers, enter first integer, that will be stored in n1. I read the second one, that will be stored in n2. Then machine will check n1 is greater than n2. Then n1 will be printed, else n2 will be printed. Same problem I solved, but this time I used if else. But I followed the rule so that interpreter can understand. If I have written, you may give the space or you may not. Then n1 is greater than n2 in the bracket. Colon is must. This left indentation is must, don't forget my dear students. Then print, then bracket and double quote, upper operate message, which value you want to print, N1. Then else must be at the left side, then colon. If you write here, error occurs. Please listen. Okay, thank you. Then this indentation is must, largest number is N2. Thank you prints every time. This is not related to alternative. That's why I changed the color for you. I hope you understood. If you enter 7 and 3, 7 is greater than 3. Yes, 7 will be printed. This will not work at all. I hope you understood. Very good. Now I'll show my notes. Okay, see my notes. In my notes I have written what are condition statement. It is nothing in front of my explanation. Not only in front of my explanation, you know more than whatever I have given in my notes. Please, whatever you know in your mind, whatever you have the ideas in your mind, write it correctly in examination. You get very good marks. Okay, then list out all. Afterwards, in last class, I taught you what is simple if and the syntax, and I explained the syntax rules. I told you last class, I told many examples. N1 is greater than N2, N1. N2 is greater than N1, N2. These are all simple if statement. These are all simple if statement. And look at this. If average is more than or equals to 35, pass. Otherwise, fail. This is what I am teaching today. If else statement. In C language, we call it. Don't write like this. You write this one. Alternative execution in Python. Please recorrect it from my notes. Give importance for this, not for this. This is what the C language. Now, this is two-way conditional statement. If the condition is true, true block works. Otherwise, false block works. There are two possibilities, but machine follows one of them. If condition colon is must, true block of statements. Else is must, colon is must, false block of statements. You can write the syntax. Give example. And we read N1 and N2. And if N1 is greater than N2, N1 will be printed, otherwise N2 will be printed. Then we read average marks. If average marks is more than equal to 35, pass, otherwise fail. I will run and I will show you the program so that you can get the confidence. Okay, I will show you how to type and how to run the program. Already I typed for you. Okay, please wait. Thank you. Okay, dear students, see this Python IDE. This is the comment I have written. Examples for alternative conditional execution statements from Python. This is a comment. Okay. To check whether the entered number is even or odd number. Just I read one number, enter a number to be checked. That will be stored in N1. If that N is divisible by 2, if the remainder is 0, 0 matches with 0, even number. Otherwise, odd number. See here colon is there, tab is there, else is there, colon is there, everything. If you have a machine, please execute and see it. Or in even you can execute in mobile also. Please practice, my dear students. And see another program I have written in the same program. To check whether you are eligible for what or not. Just we read the age, enter your age. That will be stored in the age variable. Age is more than or equals to 18. You are eligible. Else, not eligible. See the next one. And we are reading average marks. Okay, no problem. We are reading average marks. If average marks is more than equal to 35, passed. Otherwise, failed. Okay, I hope you understood. See the next one. We read year. If that year is divisible by 4, compulsory not divisible by 100. This is one condition. Divisible by 4, not divisible by 100. Then also it is leap year. No. It is divisible by 400, then also it is leap year. Okay, I taught you many times. I think you have become perfect with this. Then I may ask this one in internals. You may get this question in VTU main exam also. Then else colon, not leap year. Okay, I hope you understood. I run the program and I will show you how we are going to get the output. How to run this one? Go for run. Click on the run module. Very good. Then first code is running here. Enter number to be checked. I enter 10. Very good. Even number. Enter your age. 20. Okay. You are eligible for what? Enter your average marks. 99. Okay. Passed. Enter year to be checked. 2020. Leap year. All programs are working correctly. I think you understood. In exam, if you get a question on alternative execution statement in Python, then you get very good marks, no doubt at all. What you need to do? You need to explain what do you mean by alternative execution statement like this in your own way. Underline the important words also. Don't forget to write the syntax. If you have time, why can't you explain like me on paper itself? Then give some examples. Not only one example like this. How many examples I told you? Many examples, no? Write all these examples. Even you can write some examples by your own also. I hope I made the things very clear to you. Please, please, please watch these videos again and again. And be perfect. Practice, please. You are all intelligent. You can do well in examination. Thank you. Have a nice day. Have a nice weekend. Thank you. Take care.